Today will hopefully be the last time that we cover this topic, but because Panasonic just released new firmware and because a slew of misleading posts have already crept up about that firmware, we're once again going to be discussing the autofocus on the GH5. Let's get undone.
Gerald Undone. He's crazy.
What is happening, everybody? I'm Gerald Undone, and today we're going to talk about the new firmware for the latest generation of Lumix cameras, like the GH5, the GH5S, and the G9. The versions in question are 1.2 for the GH5S and G9, and 2.4 for the GH5, and these are the October 2018 updates. Now, as I was saying in the intro, I've covered this topic pretty thoroughly over the last year, which of course started with the 179-degree shutter angle fix back in February, and at that point, I declared the GH5 to be very usable in terms of autofocus. And I talked about this attitude a little bit in my more recent video on the evolution of autofocus. Now, this stuff is obviously based on usage scenarios and will vary from case to case, but I personally have never found the GH5 to be problematic in terms of autofocus, and it's only gotten better. And I did make a follow-up video when version 2.3 came out in May, and I suggested then that the 179-degree synchro scan trick wasn't really required anymore, and the out-of-the-box AFC performance on the GH5 was quite good, even when compared to other modern cameras. And that's where I thought this topic would be finished, but Panasonic just released version 2.4, which of course brought with it a slew of new posts and videos of people walking back and forth toward their camera, trying to see if the autofocus is any better. Now, I have prepared a couple examples to show you, but before we get into them, I want to say two things about autofocus tests in general and the latest firmware. First, although I think autofocus tests are necessary for gear guides, I also think that they're often inconclusive and extremely vulnerable to basic variants. Even if you change nothing on a camera, but you walk toward it three times, each time might give you slightly different results. So then to put on a different lens or update the firmware and claim that something has been changed or fixed can be quite misleading because it could just be simple variants. To give any kind of assertion with a degree of certainty, you would need to conduct hundreds of tests and then average them out. And I don't think many people are doing that, including myself, so it's mostly just anecdotal. Secondly, these tests become even more inaccurate when you're testing for the wrong thing. That's my biggest grievance with this recent slew of tests, is that they're not even addressing what's in the firmware update. The October 2018 firmware update is meant to address a tracking issue where the focus jumps to the background. And so a lot of the regular tests that these channels are performing don't really apply, and it's making them draw conclusions about improvements that weren't made because they can't recognize variants in their testing. It'd be like me saying, the G9 feels lighter since the latest update. Now, I didn't measure it on a scale, but it feels lighter. And that's a real nice feature. I'm glad they added that. Now, regarding the actual issue that was addressed by this firmware update, I have seen it happen a few times in my cameras, but I've never personally found it to be a highly recurring problem. In fact, it took me about 30 or 40 tries of doing a very specific action just to get it to happen so I could show you guys in this video. So here's some footage of my trusty Rubik's Cube demonstrating the problem. Now, for these shots, I was using tracking with the default AFC settings, and I was using a native mount Sigma lens, the 16mm f1.4, but I found these results to be similar with other lenses, including Panasonic ones. So what you'll see here is the focus is tracking along fine, and then it just kind of freaks out and jumps to the background. Like I said, it doesn't happen very often, but it is annoying when it does. I then updated to version 2.4 and did similar tests for about 15 minutes, and despite my efforts, I couldn't get the same problem to occur. It didn't snap to the background once, even after around 90 or so tries. So it would seem like there's definitely been an improvement there. I also tried some other stuff, like tracking the object in an H pattern, and then also doing that center spot creep in, but I didn't really find any noticeable differences between the firmware versions. I want to say that the new firmware seemed like it transitioned a bit smoother, but again, that could easily be variance or some kind of placebo effect. And I didn't find a consistently repeatable difference between the two versions when it comes to the other aspects of autofocus. I also conducted these same tests on the G9 before and after updating to version 1.2 and found similar results. Now, to talk a bit more about some of the strange information I've been seeing since this firmware release, I've seen some comments and videos that suggest that there's some new features that have been added to the face detection, and also that Panasonic has been attempting to remove the jittery, pulsing effect that happens in the background during focus. And that's just not a thing. First, there's no new features added to the face detection as far as I can tell, and there's no mention of it at all in the release notes. And that jittery pulsing thing is never going to go away because it's an integral part of how contrast detection systems work, which again I mentioned in my evolution of autofocus video. But because this video is about autofocus, I did record this entire talking head section using face detection AFC, so you can use that as more data for your decision making. But I want to be clear, I'm not suggesting that there were any changes to face detection, I just used it for the sake of it. And I did the same thing when I released my video on version 2.3, and I thought then that I was impressed with how the face detection works, and so nothing's really changed for me. So my conclusion is this, get the firmware. I can't really see any reason not to, and there's a few other minor bug fixes included as well. It's not a huge update, but it's pretty great that Panasonic is keeping them coming. And for the autofocus performance, well, I thought it was pretty good after the last update, and it's still good now, but with a minor tweak to stop it from freaking out every now and then. But that's going to be it for me. I hope you found this video helpful or at least entertaining, and if you did, make sure you leave it the old thumbs up and consider subscribing if you haven't already. But if you did not find this video helpful or entertaining, feel free to hit the dislike button twice. All right! I'm done.